follows. Now the Lord was gracious to Sarah, as he had said, and the Lord did what, and the Lord did for Sarah what he has promised. Sarah became pregnant and bore a son to Abraham in his old age, at the very time God had promised him. Abraham gave the name Isaac. Hallelujah. We can just stop from there. Hallelujah. Today we are gathered here as women. Where we are living today, God is speaking of a woman called Sarah. Sarah was a woman of faith. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says when one gets married, they become one. The Bible says God called Abraham.
Abraham.
If my friend, hallelujah. Meaning that if God can call the husband, his friend, also the wife was God's friend. Hallelujah. Where we are reading of a woman whom God has answered her prayer. This is a woman in the Bible who was married and never have kids. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm not going to read all of everything, but I'm going to summarize the story of Sarah. Hallelujah. For you to understand. Sarah was a woman of God. Hallelujah. Although the Bible does not speak much about her, it emphasizes more on Abraham. But today I want to focus on Sarah, a powerful woman of God. A powerful woman of God. What is a powerful woman? A powerful woman is a woman who prayed in the presence of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You may have everything, but if you are not known in heaven, you have a problem. When I speak of prayer, that is where the source of power comes from. You can never become powerful unless you read the word of God. Because the Bible says this book of the law must not depart from your lips, but you must meditate upon it day and night. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can be a worshiper on stage, but if you do not pray, you will scream and people will never hear you. You will never minister unto your ministry. You will never grow in your gift. It all comes down to prayer. Why am I speaking about prayer? It's because prayer works. We have seen it here in the book of Genesis. That's when Sarah prayed unto God. She is thanking God for answering her prayer. We say a God who answers prayer. When I speak of prayer, I'm not speaking of you coming to this church. I'm speaking about you in your private moment with God. Hallelujah. Speaking about you, known in the house that this woman is a woman of prayer. Even your husband knows that during this time I cannot disturb my wife because my wife is praying. Hallelujah. Some of you only pray when you come to church. It's the foundation of everything. are full of complaints in their mouth. Because they lack prayer. A woman who prays, once when she opens her mouth, the Bible says things begin to happen. A woman who prays, whenever she calls upon God, she
comes
by faith, knowing that God is going to answer my prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Regardless what you have prayed for, what is more important when I speak of prayer is the relationship between you as a woman and God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some of you are alone in the church. The Bible says, not all who call me Lord, Lord shall enter the kingdom of God. It says, bring up your salvation who is trembling. Hallelujah. You could be married, but prayer is an individual thing, and it takes commitment.
And
they want to be serious in prayer. Also, studying the word of God. Some of you do not study the word of God. You cannot pray without the word of God. If there is a language that God understands, it is His way. Hallelujah. If there is a language that God understands, it's when you speak of the word of God. Some of you read the Bible once a week. Some of you only read the Bible when you come to church. You feel like because you're not the teacher or the leader in the church, it's not important for you to read the word of God. The word of God is important. It is also the foundation of the source of power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some of you eat every day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The whole week you are eating. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You need to take time aside as a woman. And pray before God. By fasting and prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some of you only fast when they call a fast in the church.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But you cannot take up a decision on your own to take 3 days on your own. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To take 3 days on your own. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is very, very important.
It's not all on
hallelujah.
That is where the power comes from.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we read the Bible, women of power are women who keep on pushing. Women of power are women who never give up. A woman of power are women who are not discouraged in the presence of God. Even when things are not going right in their marriages, they keep on moving. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They keep on moving. Even if you have a prayer request before God, and your prayer request has not yet been answered,
and
it doesn't change the relationship you have with God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible speaks of
Sarah,
a woman who feared the Lord. Hallelujah. A woman who was humble before God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says, Sarah was not perfect. She was a woman with history.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
She was like you and me in this day. The Bible says one day, when things were tight, she spoke to the husband,
hallelujah,
and said that, Papa, since I cannot give birth, can you stick with this woman? Hallelujah.
Amen.
These are some of the mistakes that we made as women.
Hallelujah.
We open doors for the devil to come in.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says when she was suggesting for Abraham, to help another woman in her life, she thought she was solving the problem.
Guys,
she was bringing more problem to what she was calling for. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 When you pray, you need to have faith in God. Hallelujah. And trust that God is going to do what you have asked Him to do.
Hallelujah.
God does not change His mind. The Bible says, as time goes on, some of us as women, we stop praying unto God. We switch our focus on God. We begin to do our own things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As a woman of God, you need to teach your children to be God-fearing children. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You need to teach your children at the young age to follow God. Hallelujah. Don't wait until they're old. To introduce God unto their lives. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We need a woman who was called Hagar. Hagar was a single parent. You could be here on this. As a single parent. It doesn't mean that when you are a single parent, God does not hear your prayer.
And
God does not see you when you pray. Because the Bible is teaching us that during the time when Hagar started the fight, God had to meet her halfway and speak to her on your way and go back to your master. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some of us, when you have kids, as a single mother, you feel like there's nobody going to baby you.
Hallelujah.
Wait upon God.
Even
God who is faithful, at the right time,
He will
give you your blessing. You might be having a kid. You might be having two children. It doesn't change the man of God to you. It doesn't change the we are having problems. We cannot give birth. And then a love affair started from there. You cannot speak to someone. You may not know this, but there was a relationship between the two. To the fact that it affected
Sarah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's what I'm telling you, stop it.
Don't
go to your husband's phone. Give it from your own phone.
You're
the source of power. Which is God. When you die,
you
find that the money or that is an example about me.
Many nash confused.
When I got that, I'm saying it's important. If you have not asked, pray to God and ask
over this.
In a good, like, cook a good meal. Hallelujah. You sit down with him.
And then
you normalize this thing. Hallelujah. When I got married, my husband, before we got married, his beneficiary, was the younger brother. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't assume that because you are married to that man,
you are
automatically covered. And how did I found out? I asked. Am I the beneficiary? I'm working hard in this marriage. Don't undermine yourself. Be a wife with an achievement. Increase your achievement. That's why God respect marriage. And then he told me, no. Because the beneficiary is the younger brother. I told him, I just prayed about this. And then I told him, I think now that you're married, you can change from the brother to me. Hallelujah. And bring documentations. Hallelujah. Don't just think to say, I'll change. And it changed. Hallelujah. But if you keep quiet, you'll be shocked. Some of you are aware that there are kids outside. And you think because they are far away, the husband is not thinking of them. He's thinking of them. No man forgets his children. Not all of them, but some. They remember that I have a son. Like what Abraham did when he died.
Yes, Abraham was the end
of life. He remembered that he has a son.
Ishmael.
The Bible says he gave son. Little bit. Hallelujah. You must control this thing. Little bit of it. Went to Ishmael. And the other kids of Abraham. After when Sarah passed away. It's not a sin to ask a man if you're covered or not. And if he has a life cover, you need to find out. No, we're not saying that all the policies must be the beneficiary. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's biblical. It's biblical. We learned this from Sarah. When she spoke while she was still alive, things were fixed while she was still alive. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And we're not saying that the man must be the only one taking the policies. Hallelujah. Even when a man says he has covered his mother, you can also cover your mother-in-law. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Women of power. When I speak of women of power, I'm speaking of a woman like
Sarah.
The Bible says when she had problems, she never thought of divorce. She never thought of divorce. Some of you keep on confessing, I will divorce him. I will divorce you. Where's a portal? Hallelujah. When there is a problem in your marriage, never ever confess with your mouth.
You
tell your husband that I will divorce you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You speak to God. Who is the source? And I'm the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Some of you are surprised. Why is she speaking of divorce? Because
you're
not allowed to divorce. Hallelujah. If you relax, in your marriage, you let go of yourself. You let go of yourself. But because of lack of respect, some of you don't even respect your husband at home. The Bible says you must be submissive to your husband. Regardless of how much he's earning, whether he's working or not, the fact remains that he's your husband. Every day you are comparing your husband. The Bible says, "Sarah never compared Abraham to anyone." The Bible says she respected him to the point that she called him his master. Hallelujah. When there are issues, you go to the dining room where there are kids. Hallelujah. When you speak of lack of respect, it's not only by speaking. Even your action towards your husband. Some of you are dressed up ugly. You may find that you forgot to prepare breakfast for your husband this morning. And you will end up saying that you wish my husband.
Amen.
Some of the things that are happening in marriage or that causes problem in marriage is when women lack respect. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says, even if your husband preaches like nobody's business, and then you find that he's sitting with his friends drinking, and then he calls to bring me another beer. I'm born again, I will not bring that
thing.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm telling you, people like Esther.
Man, not funny like Esther.
When the Bible says King Sector was a drunk. When he called for Vashti to come and display her beauty. He was drunk. And she knew about this problem. You think a woman out of nowhere can just say, I won't come? It did not start from that day. She had a problem with him before. Hallelujah. She had a problem before. Some of us would just think it was for that day. He just got there and then she refused. The Bible says Vashti was beautiful. If you don't respect your husband,
you don't want to know where.
He doesn't speak of a
finger.
A woman with a finger, look at the wish him. A woman with a finger will move in.
One second of finger, it can't
get
in. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says you shall know the truth and the truth shall set you free.
You
want to save marriages today.
He never said that but my mother.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You need to play your part as a woman. Since your husband met you, you've been doing black of black of clothes. You need to change your hairstyle. Hallelujah.
It's been
short hair all the way. Short hair, short hair.
I don't know why.
You need to change the way you look. Hallelujah. Sarah was hot.
Sarah asked us to deal.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
To the point that Abraham, wherever he went, he said, you know my wife, must tell them I'm my sister. The man are probably out there late.
It's late.
Forgetting.
Urivala.
That before he could come home,
well, I'm a swim dream.
He thought of you. That's why he came home. If there was no you,
he could have
stayed for the whole night. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What a man wants to see.
Lord, let's run out of
the way. If a woman, when he comes in,
such a man of
and then you're watching TV, you don't want to talk to your husband. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Never ever put your husband on a silent mood. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He woke up in the morning, he's not talking to you because you are angry. Being a woman of boldness, if she is bothered by something,
do
not go with me to bed. Hallelujah. You need to appreciate. You need to appreciate your woman, your man, when it comes home. Let me tell you something.
Imagine
when the cuckoo buys that.
Let's not happen.
I'm not saying there's a cuckoo buying your husband's
food. Hallelujah.
When they see your man, out there, they get excited.
That's all.
They get excited.
That's
they can't wait to kiss the man. They can't wait to see the man. They keep on checking their hairstyles. You see now, I'm a mother. My stomach was not like this. Now it has got some stuff in here.
Supernatural.
The Bible describes Esther. She was a woman with figure.
For anyone such a figure.
Yeah.
Some of the problem, if you do not avoid them,
no matter avoid to want to hear,
you'll end up being in trouble or your marriage being in trouble.
That is how you do not want to hear.
Because of you opening a door for the devil.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Sometimes,
now you mind,
when a man comes home, hallelujah, you don't even take off his jacket.
I wish you put in a jacket.
Some of you, your husband spent the whole day at work. You don't even send an SMS to say, I love you.
I will send you a message. You are going to
red.
You got a problem. Wrong time, that man. To the fact that when he thinks of you, he really lies coming home.
He wants to turn up.
Hallelujah. You don't even ashamed for the whole day. You never forget your husband. These are my witnesses. My husband called me.
No, no, man, it's one for me.
And they don't know because I said their services.
And the first
last night was wow. And you can't wait for tomorrow. You keep on complaining of a headache. A headache, that is
your own.
Where is the headache? Here. You're here. You are eating more. You are eating more. No. You are eating more. You are eating more. if you are fasting. Or you are thinking, well, indeed. Some of you, when he wakes you at 3, you pretend as if you are sleeping. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those are the type of excuses.
Iti excuse the name.
Have you ever seen yourself when you are hungry? You can eat anything. The same goes for men.
She should not go on moon.
A sister church will bend like this.
Sister can't get a cup of Ramasaw. And so we're going to get.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Feed your men.
Feed them in our way.
Feed your men.
Feed them in our way.
If you want to fetch your salvation,
I never go after him down.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Will I ever enjoy making love?
Nah, that's not going to enjoy I'm better again.
What does that tell you?
So good that I am.
The woman has been enjoying.
I'm being.
It has been given to you by God to enjoy.
Yeah.
The Bible says,
yes, amen.
Some of you, you forget the most important part.
The one mama made me a shambo or shambo.
That part is very important. Don't go to bed with your pajamas. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Every time you go, that old gown, when you wake up, you take that old gown.
Now it's summer.
Say summer,
Jesus.
My younger sister is here, she will tell you. I buy shorts like here.
You don't like shorts.
But when I go to the dining room, I respect myself.
Hallelujah.
I take the gown to cover it up. But when I'm waiting in my bedroom, I am a woman of God. When I display my beauty, don't hide your assets from your bed.
Oh,
but you assets from
away.
Oh, let's teach you. Everything must be replicated.
And what is going to be believed? What is going to be believed?
The first woman, Eve.
Once I was a Eva.
They were always naked around each other. There's nothing wrong with that. Every time when you go to bed, you go in with your panties and men still have to take off the panties. Go in there naked. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You still have your own panties.
Why not panties?
What? Shame on you. We're not saying go to Akame or wherever.
I ain't from Akame.
It is Pep that's selling good panties.
I think Pep that's selling such a panties.
I waited for him at the bedroom.
No,
it did not take too long.
I feel like
It was weak. Because the man was attracted. He saw something that he has never seen before. Every time. It must be the man starting touching you. Let's just choose the key. Hallelujah. We don't want him to be dead.
There was a woman who had maids.
And you have a helper in the house. Make sure that when you are not working, you take your full responsibility as a woman. Some of you have shifted the responsibility to the maid. Hallelujah.
Amen.
She is a helper in the house. Do not take advantage of that woman.
Take advantage, yeah.
Now she must also go to your bedroom and prepare your bedroom. Why should I underwear your husband's underwear? Some of the things remain to be your responsibility as a woman.
Hallelujah.
Amen.